If there's one thing that I appreciate the most about Fantech as a relatively budget brand, it's the fact that they prioritize quality over quantity, at least for their flagship gaming mouse lineup. When you hear the model name Helios, you know for sure that it's from Fantech. And if you fell in love with the Helios XD3 V2's shape and size back in 2022, you'll be delighted to know that you can still get the same size and shape but with modern features that can compete with the current meta. Things like lighter weight, better build quality and coating, better micro switches, better connectivity and sensor, modern 4000 to 8000 Hz polling rate, and a lot more in between. The adjustment period should be pretty seamless in case you choose to upgrade. In today's video, we're going to check out the latest iteration of the Fantech Helios gaming mouse with the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S, a slight but definitely appreciated update from its predecessor that was launched just less than a year ago. Almost everything the community asked for, they've implemented, from better coating and upgraded polling rate to going back to the tried and tested WANA Blue Shell Pink Dot micro switches. Should you upgrade? Let's talk about it. Let's get into it. As always, honest disclaimer, this video is not paid, but Fantech did provide both the Fantech Helios Pro and Pro S for me to experience. They will not review this video and will see this at the same time as you do. With that out of the way, let's do a quick comparison first before I share with you the rest of my thoughts about the latest Fantech Helios 2 Pro S. Packaging-wise, they look almost the same with an image preview of some of the key features in front and all the notable specifications at the back. We'll tackle each of these specifications in detail later. Inside the box of the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S, we have the mouse itself, a plastic platform, then underneath that we have the user manual and an accessory box that houses a bunch of items. So we have a set of stickers, a warranty card, a nice letter from the CEO of Fantech, and we even have a sort of coin right here that adds to the overall premium unboxing experience. We also have some replacement PTFE gliders, and not only that, but it also comes with alternative dot gliders to reduce weight if you're into that. We also have some grip tapes and the Strike Speed Plus 4K polling rate booster. By the way, you can also use this at 8K polling rate via wired mode using the included braided cable. However, we don't have the standard 2.4GHz USB dongle anymore for the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S. So yeah, aside from the dongles, both models have pretty much the same package contents. Now, putting them both side by side, as you can tell, they look exactly the same. In fact, the shape and size are exactly the same starting from the Fantech Helios XD3 V2 if this information from eloshapes.com is accurate. So yeah, shape, size, and design-wise, both models look identical. But make no mistake about it, there are a few subtle improvements here. The PTFE gliders of the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S are noticeably thicker, the coating is significantly better, and the primary buttons are also better, going back to the traditional mechanical switches with the tried and tested transparent WANA Blue Shell Pink Dot micro switches. And while the scroll wheel is essentially the same F-switch encoder, I feel like the tactile notches on the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S are slightly more pronounced. The Fantech Helios 2 Pro S also has an improved MCU with a Nordic 52840 for low latency input and to accommodate the higher wired 8K polling rate. Also, while it's not visible, the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S build construction has been improved as well to minimize creaking and flexing. And to get a better understanding of that, here's a quick sound test for you guys. However, as per my testing, my Fantech Helios 2 Pro S is heavier at 56.8 grams compared to the 54.6 grams of the older Fantech Helios 2 Pro. Both, by the way, are specified at 55 grams. Fantech said that this varies depending on the color and switches used, so there's that. If you want to make it lighter, you can use the included dot PTFE gliders instead. Other than those things that I've mentioned, everything else is still the same. Same size, shape, design, and with same reliable PixArt 3395 sensor. Alright, so with the side-by-side comparison out of the way, let's move our focus now on the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S. Even though you had a pretty good idea already, let's still do the usual parts overview. Looking up top, as I pointed out earlier, the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S features a better coating, which to be honest is quite noticeable. I can definitely feel that it is more grippy, even though the texture is fairly smooth. I also prefer this transparent Huano Blue Shell Pink Dot Micro Switches. It's crispy and doesn't feel annoyingly crunchy, unlike the optical switches of the Fantech Helios 2 Pro. The primary buttons also don't have any pre or post travel, and are fairly satisfying to click. The scroll wheel is also quite robust. It doesn't have any side-to-side wobble, has solid tactile notches, and easy-to-press middle button. Looking at the left side, we have the forward and back buttons that are easy to press and have a decent amount of tactile and click feedback. Nothing to complain about here. You can also get a good view of the shape here with a not-so-tall bump towards the rear end. We also have a nice subtle Helios 2 Pro S branding right here. Looking at the back, you can get a good view of that symmetrical shape with a very small Fantech logo at the center. On the other side, basically clean. By the way, it also has a nice curvature towards the rear end that provides a little bit more support for your palm. In front, as you can tell, the primary buttons have a small curvature to guide your fingers towards the center. By the way, before I forget, should you choose to use this in wired mode for that 8K polling rate, just take note that the included cable is quite stiff, especially for today's standard. Well, at least the opening for the USB port is fairly wide at around 12.1 by 6.4 mm, just in case you want to use custom cables. Lastly, looking at the bottom, we have two large PTFE gliders with a small one around the PixArt 3395 sensor. We also have the switch for the tri-mode connectivity, a DPI button, and a small LED indicator on top of it. This is the only illumination we have for this mouse, which I don't mind at all. In terms of grip styles, due to the bump towards the rear end, this is suitable for both palm and claw grip users, but as a hybrid claw and fingertip user, I'm still perfectly fine with this. Now in terms of performance, this is where the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S stands out the most. With a reliable PixArt 3395 sensor, partnered with the comfortable shape and 4000Hz polling rate wirelessly, the performance is something I really appreciate about this mouse. Partnered with a pretty decent 240Hz OLED gaming monitor, the performance of the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S is quite accurate and smooth and noticeably better compared to all my other 1000Hz gaming mice. I feel like it's kinda hard to go back to 1000Hz after trying 4000Hz. I don't know if it's just a placebo effect, but I can definitely feel some difference. No spin-outs, no jittering, no unnecessary movements, just pure accuracy. Now in terms of the software, it's pretty much what you would expect at this price range. Basic but useful software. Inside, you can change the functionalities of all the buttons except for the left primary button. You can also restore, import, and export settings, adjust the debounce time, and create up to 4 profiles. Now, under the second page, we have up to 4 DPI stages, and you can adjust the values in increments of 50. You can also adjust polling rates up to 4000Hz, and adjust other settings like power settings, lift off distance, sleep mode, and others. Under the macro page, of course, you can record macros, and then on the settings page, we have the rest of the settings such as device information, pairing, and others. Overall, to conclude, in terms of design, construction, features, and performance, the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S pretty much has everything. It's definitely a well-refined version of its predecessor, bringing all the community feedback to life as it should. I have no complaints about this mouse, at least for everything it has to offer. It essentially checks all my boxes. The only thing that's nagging my mind here is the price. As far as I know, this is the most expensive gaming mouse Fantech has ever released at around 4,950 Philippine pesos. That's borderline mid-range category already. And for a bit more than that, you can probably get something with a magnesium alloy shell with the same sensor and specifications. But if you're already used to the size and shape and you simply want to upgrade, then by all means, get the Fantech Helios 2 Pro S. Trust me, you won't regret it. And there you have it guys, thank you for watching. Huge thanks to Fantech Philippines for sending this in. You can get this using the link below. Again, this is not paid and Fantech will see this video at the same time as you do. Now, if you want an ergonomic gaming mouse with pretty much the top-of-the-line specifications, watch my review of the ROG Keras 2 Ace by clicking this. Thank you for watching, subscribe if you appreciate this video, and see you next time. Have a great day guys, you're awesome.